and Jeff. They made it to Blazor Puzzle, episode 81.
81, man.
81.
Ah, yeah. It's a beautiful thing.
I am in Stockholm, Sweden, at DevSum.
This is a good time of year to be in Stockholm.
Oh, it's beautiful here.
Yeah. I only ever get there in February. Hmm.
Yeah. Well, anyway, I did a Blazor workshop today.
Oh, terrific.
It was great fun.
Always great to teach new folks all about the Blazor.
Yep. And I kind of had an epiphany today, but I'm not going to say anything about it. I'm just going to start working on a new tool that's going to help, I think. It's going to help. So
looking forward to seeing what you got.
Yeah, with that, let's roll the crazy music, and you've got a new puzzle to show everybody. Go for it.
Yeah, let's do this. So I've run into this scenario a couple of times, and I've heard from some customers that want to do something like this. And I've mocked it up here in the browser that I have on the right side of the screen. And the idea is they've got a couple of components that they're building out that they want to put on a dashboard on the homepage of their website.
Yeah.
So I mocked this up with a couple of just generic components, place it on a standard Blazor Global Server Interactive website. It's out there. You can find it in the Puzzle 81 repository. And you see the source code here for my home Razor. I'm referencing my Razor class library, my components, and I'm bringing in my sales chart, and it's just got some dummy data here, and my KPI summary, and once again, some dummy data here that we're just mocking up.
So the idea is you want a dashboard where people can add and remove and move around components, right?
I don't even want to go that far. We don't need to go to the full SharePoint customization thing yet. But as new requirements come up, I want to be able to add them to this page without having to rebuild and redo my layout every time and going and discovering things. I want to hand off that ability to load and define the components on this page somewhere else.
Okay. All right. And is that all you're going to tell us for this challenge?
That's all we're going to start off here. We've got these two components. And if you look in my source code here, I've actually got a third component that we've already got built here called Team Activity. That's going to show some of the recent activity of our team. And I'd like to put that on the homepage without actually having to come in here and type, you know,
hard code it. Yeah.
Hard code it. My components. Team activity, and you know, I can let Hot Reload do that, and it adds it to the page. But now, when the next component comes along, I'm gonna have to update my home page again.
Yeah, you want something where you can control that.
Yeah.
How do you do it?
How can you do that?
So help us out, friends. Help Jeff make his dashboard more dashboardy.
Yeah, I'm lazy. I don't want to keep updating that homepage.
Yeah, and if you want to see the answer, just stick around because we'll be back in a few seconds, and Jeff's going to show you the answer. But if you want to try to think about it, cogitate on it a little bit, figure it out, just hit pause. We'll be here when you get back.
All right. All right. So this is where we left off with these three components that are hard-coded in here, and I want to simplify that. And what we can do is we can set up a interface that will define that these are dashboard components, register them, set up a little component registry, and then do a for loop across the components in that registry.
Hmm.
Let me show you what I'm talking about here. So I put together a little class library called shared, and you can see it down here. And I've added an interface to it called dashboard component. Nothing to it right now. We can add stuff to it later, but I just need this as a marker so that I know that these are dashboard components that we're going to add. And inside my Razor class library, I wrote a little class called startup. And startup extends those interfaces that we have on Program.cs so that as we're building our service collection, we can add registrations using our dashboard component interface and the names of the component that we want to register. So on those components, I make sure that I'm implementing our marker interface with the at implements directive here right at the top. And this lets me then, inside of my new homepage, add an inject here that says, go inject the dashboard components, the IEnumerable, the collection of dashboard components that are registered.
And you're using dynamic component.
Yeah.
So dynamic component, we've talked about a little bit before. It's a way that you can have data-driven components, basically, instantiation.
It's almost like reflection, right? Being able to say, hey, here's a component I want you to use, and it will go find that and launch it for you. So I have the site running over here. If I go back into my little startup class and I remove one of these, so let's remove the KPIs, right? Save that. Mm-hmm. And in just a second, it's going to hot reload and we'll see the little KPI section here disappear. Oh, I've got to refresh. I've got to restart it because it's in program. Program has to be updated.
Of course. Okay.
And there it is. It's gone.
Yep. Okay.
So now I have control to update and put new content on the homepage by updating things in the Razor class library.
Nice.
So as the big boss, as the vice president, head of marketing says, hey, I want additional features to show up on the website, I just update my Razor class library. The rest of the web works the same way, and it will just dynamically add those new features.
Wow, that's very cool, Jeff.
Yeah.
Yeah, and dynamic component strikes again.
Yeah, this is a cool way to start building vertical slices of your application, moving them out into those Razor class libraries so they get loaded in and built as need be and as the application grows, without having to maintain and update the central website that contains all these features.
I love it. So this was a great puzzle, Jeff. And if you've got a great puzzle, whether or not you have the solution, send it to us by email at blazorpuzzle@appvnext.com. And if we use it on the show, we're going to send you a Blazor Puzzle mug and mention you on the show.
Yeah.
And hopefully, and you know, yeah, fame and fortune. Well, fame anyway. Well, maybe, that's right. Maybe infamy.
You're fortunate to be on the show.
Yeah, there you go. All right, we'll see you next week, kids. Bye-bye.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out blazortrain.com and the .NET Show.com for more great content.